It's now time for the nationally syndicated radio show that brings nothing but heat. Spit fire, save the matches radio.
Yeah. Oh, he throwing up the W for sure.
Hey, man, it's the only way to start it, brother.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Spitfire Save the Matches Radio Podcast, all the above. I'm the man behind the boards, DJ D Poise. And of course, we got a West Coast representative, Dazzie Dee, in the building, ladies and gentlemen.
What it do, love? Well, how you doing, brother?
Man, I'm good. Good. Man, I guess what I want to know off top, man, how'd you get your name, man? That's a unique name. There's got to be a story behind that.
Oh, man, yeah, man. Well, you know, I'm old school, man. So I had a name, man, D-Rock Skeet in junior high. They used to call me D-Rock Skeet. Yeah, oh, man. You know, I just grew out of it, man. And then I kind of got corny for a minute. I was calling myself Dazzling D. You know what I'm saying? And right. That ain't gonna cut it. So we shopped it from Dazzling to just Dazzy, man.
Okay. Yeah, it sounds like you got a lot of influence from the East Coast, man. I mean,
yeah,
quite a bit.
I mean, you know, the first couple records I got a hold to was from the East, so you know, I got to respect it, man.
What was those records?
Rakim.
Oh, okay.
And Fat Boys, you know what I'm saying? Curtis. Okay. Super Rhymes.
You know Super Rhymes.
Yeah, man. All that good stuff, man.
That sounds like what you said when you said it's your name, it kind of gave me the Roski, like Kuwaski.
Exactly.
Fat Boys, yeah. I was like, okay. Yeah,
Fat Boys, yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah. Rest in peace, Prince Marky D.
Real talk. Him and Buff. Rest in peace. Buff,
yeah, man. That's so. Would it be safe to say that you were good at beatboxing?
Nah. I mean, I could do it, but nah, that wasn't my thing. I was better at pop locking than I was at beatboxing.
Oh, word.
Yeah.
Oh shoot.
Yeah.
That seemed like that was a pretty big thing on the West Coast, the pop locking and the was breaking any spinning and on the ground? Were y'all more about the pop locking than anything?
Pop lock, you know, it kind of came from the regular locking, you know what I'm saying, like the LA Lockers and all that, LA Rockets and all that. They was locking. And then, you know, it went off into pop locking. And then, you know, the East Coast kind of came with the breaking. I mean, it was cats out here, you know, breaking. It was cats out here, what they do. But, yeah, it's just a time thing for me. You know what I'm saying? When I got popping. It was popular. So that's when I got into popping.
I think some of the earlier influences of breaking came from the West Coast, because I think some of us got exposed to breaking from the movie Breaking, which was on the West Coast. I believe I'm remembering correctly.
That's crazy. Yeah, man. I remember that movie. I remember Breaking.
Yeah. Was like, dang, that's how they do it down there.
Yeah.
And then I think what? Beach Street came. I think Breaking came before. I don't know now. Let me think.
Yeah.
I'm not really sure which one came first.
Yeah, that's a good question, man. I don't know. I think Beach Street might have came first.
Beach Street.
Not sure, you know what I'm saying, and I think Crush Groove probably came before all that, right?
You know what? Wow, that is a good question. That's a hip hop question, there, ain't it? We need a hip hop historian to come in here and educate us a little bit on that.
Yeah,
I think I'm stunned on that one, bro. That's a good question. So coming from South Central LA,
yes, sir.
Born and raised,
brother.
Oh, man, that's what's up, man.
Yeah.
You got a history with the lynch mob.
Yes, sir.
You were one of the original members of the Lynch Mob, right?
Yes, sir.
But I never understood, what was there a reason why you left to do your own thing, or was it other issues involved?
Yeah, it was just other things, like, you know, truthfully, the Lynch Mob really wasn't supposed to be an actual group. It was more of a clique. It was more, you know what I'm saying? More of a, it was just homies, because, you know, we had different factions. You feel me? Like, you know, Cam had his own camp. You know, me and Jinx was doing our own thing. Q was doing his own thing. KD was doing his thing. Yo-Yo was doing her thing. So we collectively got together to become the Lynch Mob. It really wasn't supposed to be like an actual, you know, group thing. You feel me? But it ended up being business called for it. And, you know, everybody was kind of waiting in line for their time. And, you know, I just didn't want to really wait. You know what I'm saying? Plus, there was a few things they were going in a direction I really wasn't really feeling at that time. So, yeah, it was just time for me to exit and do my thing.
So, were you on the second album, or were you on both albums?
Yeah, now, you know, actually, I wasn't on any of those albums. I was just...
Really?
I didn't fly to L.A. I mean, I didn't fly to New York when they started on America's Most. I was out of town doing what I do. And then when they came back, that's when I jumped on tour. And I was on tour for like 3 years. Facebook Cube, you know, Cube and the rest of the mob. So I was doing my stage thing, and I was doing a lot of writing and stuff behind the scenes because I was getting ready. I was getting ready for my project.
Okay. Oh, well, back then, you already was in process. Oh, okay. That's what's up. So you knew.
Yes, sir.
You knew right then and there that you was going to do your own thing.
And it was no love lost, because actually Cube, actually, you know, once I left, Cube was like, well, at least let me get on the album. You know what I'm saying? And Cube paid for the studio time, and he knocked off the song, and, you know, so it was all love.
That's what's up. That's what's up, man. I'm glad it wasn't no bad vibes or nothing like that, or, you know,
just too many of us. You know what I'm saying? I look at it like we was basically the first Death Row. You know what I'm saying? Death Row. So it was just so many factions, man, and so many cliques that, you know, it, you know, to stand in that line and just wait your turn, man. You know, I was too young, and I was too hungry to do that. You feel me? So I just
Okay. Okay, yeah, I don't blame you then. You know, you was hungry.
Like I said, Q couldn't blame me. He didn't blame me. He wasn't mad. He understood.
Yeah. So this album that's out right now, man, the West Coast Boombap Slam. Did I read correctly? This is gonna be your last joint?
Yeah, this is the last album, man. West Coast Boom Slap, man. It's my last one. Yes, the last one, man. I think I went out with a bang on this one, bro.
Yeah, man. What, man, you think you're getting too old or something, man? Why you, or you got other things in mind?
Probably just a little bit, you know what I'm saying? I'm getting a little older, but I'm also just seeing how the industry is going, man. And, you know, it's just really one of those things now where, with the industry, homie, it's just microwave, you know what I'm saying? You know, I'm old school, man, so I take time doing my albums, you know what I'm saying? I get everything mixed, mastered. So, you know, my projects take about 3-4 months, you know what I'm saying? And the way this industry is going right now, so microwave, man, you could take 4 months on working on a project, and, you know, a month after it's out, people already start to ask you when you drop the next one.
Yeah, you're right. you're right. Goodness.
So, I mean, it's just what it is, what it is, man. So, yeah, I'm going to still do my thing. I'll probably drop songs. You feel me? Like singles.
Okay.
Go that route, man. Like I said, with the microwave generation, you know, I think they can appreciate a single better. You know, next month, hit them with another single. 2 months later, hit them with another single. You know, I'm definitely still going to be active. But as far as full-blown projects like this one, nah, I think this is my last one.
So, can we get, like, all your singles after they've been released over, let's say you drop a single every month, and then after a year, could we see you possibly dropping the full project with all of the drop for the year? Like, we could just be like, yo, can I get them all together instead of just getting grabbing them up myself? Or
yes, sir. What Great Minds Think Alike, brother. I actually did. Okay. I dropped a project about 5 months ago called Rewind. And it was basically the same thing, just songs I've been dropping over, like, say, past 15 years. I together and made a cool little project out of it.
Okay. Okay. I agree with you, but I'm old school, so I'm used to having like the whole project and putting it on in the whip and letting it ride and riding through the whip or chilling at the crib playing the whole project, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, me too, brother. Me too. Me too. Like I said, you know, to the average fan, man, they don't quite see it that way. So it's just like, it's just a lot of work, man, you know. Like I said, because we really, me and my bro Slag Dog, man, he helped co-produce the album with me. You know, we put a lot of effort in that, man, for us to turn around. And, you know, because I'm old school like you. Remember, man, you know, albums to come out, man, they could work that out for a whole year. You feel me? Sometimes even 2 years if they had enough slaps on them, right?
Yeah.
So I come from that era, man, and, you know, so just to turn around and, you know, cast me like, okay, what's next? And it's only been a month out, like,
Well, that's a good thing and a bad thing. I guess it's they love you so much, they just want you to keep hitting them with more bangers, but yeah, it's a lot of, but you want to continue to put out quality out, is what I'm assuming.
Yeah. There you go, quality, man. I'm an NWA baby, man. I'm a Dr. Dre baby. I'm not even a cousin or a nephew. I'm a brother. You know what I'm saying? I came from that camp. So I understand, like you say, quality. You know what I'm saying? I really do, man. And it take a lot, man. It take a lot to really do that. You feel me? It take time to do all that. So I just want people to appreciate it.
So Dre also worked on some of your music in the early days, right?
Yes, sir. Great?
Wow. Yeah.
Him and Jinx. I was best friends with Jinx, and so me and Jinx were around a lot every day. And this is when Dre was staying with Jinx. So, you know, it was one time where, cause like I said, I always been a hip hop head, man. I always been a beat boy. So, right when Real Roxanne and all them dissed JJ Fab, with this record. So, you know, he knew I was so much into hip hop, and, you know, he knew I could pull that low. I end up writing the diss song for JJ Fad, and then in return, Dre ended up producing a couple songs on my single, on my maxi single after that.
Wow. You said maxi single. I heard that one in a long time too, bro. Man, them
cool with it, man.
Yeah, man. You were a true hip hop.
Yes, sir.
I would say somewhat of a historian, man, because you was part of the history, you know, coming up.
Yes, sir. And actually, that maxi single I'm talking about came out on under VIP Records in Long Beach, Calvin Anderson. He was the label I was signed to back then. So yeah, man, all of it tied together, man. Definitely some history.
That is history. Wow. And you got a lot of couple features on this album too. One of them being I think I read your son is on this record.
My son Junior, he on the first song. My daughter Chocolate, she got an interlude. And then I got my rhyme partner Dal Poeta on the song, and then I got that bomb super fire Lynch Mob reunion record.
Nice. That is a banger right there. That was one of the records I was really banging to the hardcore, like in the whip on the way home. Like, yo, is this the Lynch Mob? What's up with the Lynch Mob, man? Y'all all getting back together to do a full project, or is just kind of a
You know, once again, man, everybody kind of doing their thing, like they did back in the day. Everybody kind of doing their thing, but I think now, you know, we're a little more organized and life has slowed down a little bit to where, you know, we can bang out a few more of those. You know what I'm saying? And eventually figure it out, come together, figure it out.
Yo, it also said you used to DJ for what? Man, did you DJ for Quick?
Yeah, I was Quick too. Yeah.
Wait, DJ Quick needed a DJ. Wow.
That's, yeah. I was a DJ for a minute.
Did you ever do anything with Quick? Like, did you ever do any production or anything with Quick?
Yeah, man, we stayed doing production. Me and him produced Sugar Free album.
That's okay.
Together.
Uh oh.
Yeah, we produced the Mossberg album, Rest in Peace, together. We produced a lot of records together, man. Like, I, that camp was together about 6 years. We did a lot in 6 years, man.
Man, you know what? I'm just glad that a lot of cats that was from, well, my era are still doing it. And when you said I'm about to retire, I was like, nah, please don't, because we need some. I want to say grown folks hip hop, bro. We need.
Yeah, man. I mean, like I said, I'm not gonna walk away from music. I love it too much, man. I just love the game too much, though, man, to deal with that microwave. I can't do it, bro. I mean, you know, because rappers are spoiled. You know, rappers spoil artists. You know, their fans these days, man. Like, you know, a lot of that trap stuff, man. You know, they be dropping 2-3 albums a year. You know what I'm saying? But you know, so you know, I can understand fans being spoiled, man. But you know, like I said, it's quality, man. Somebody called my album, my bro King Tech called that album timeless. You know, and that's what I wanted. Every project like that, you feel me? Make it timeless. So I just want to make sure we're right, bro.
Just based on the fact that you combine the West Coast vibe with the New York vibe, so there ain't no doubt that. You can't be like, well, I rock with the East or I rock with the West. You gonna get both on this album. You gonna get a combination of the two on this album that gives you that, you know, what's not to love about it? You know what I mean? If you love either or whatever coast, you gonna love this.
Yeah, that was the game plan, man. Real. You know, the thing about it is, man, a lot of my peers, you know, from the West, man, we lost our sound for a minute, right? So we kind of didn't really have a sound. And, you know, a lot of our younger artists kind of got that trap flow because we don't have our particular sound. And I didn't even want to tamper with that. You know, so I get a youngster that's their sound and their vibe. But one thing I wanted to do with this album, man, is that hip hop, man, boom bap is just timeless. It's timeless. It's, you know, it had been through its ups and downs. It had been through, but it's just the essence. It is what it is. So I said, okay, if I'm gonna stick with this music, let me stick to that. Let me stick to the essence because I can't go wrong with that.
I'm so glad you brought that part up about the older artists rapping over the younger people's music.
Yeah.
And it's okay if you was. From you came up with that sound, but to come from New York and do trap beats and or to come from the West Coast and do trap beats, it just don't always sound right to me. It don't even sound original to me. It just, you know, exactly. What I mean?
That it's a look, man, this is trap's time. You know what I'm saying? Trap did have what, a good 10 year run, maybe even a 15-year run. So you know, man, it's a lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? Trap, you got to kind of be in that lifestyle to really understand it and make it do what it do. And I'm definitely not part of that lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? So I respect that, man. And a lot of my peers aren't from that either. So that's why I sound a little weird when they try to pull it off.
Yeah. I remember when the time West Coast was killing the game. And I guess maybe I'm tripping because maybe at a time there was a lot of South artists trying to sound like West Coast artists. Maybe... Yeah. I just didn't realize it. Maybe it was. I didn't, you know, it didn't seem like it to be, but
yeah,
maybe it was. You know?
Exactly. I mean, you know, we had our run. That's what I'm saying. You feel me? Like, you know, we had, what, a good 10-year run. Mm-hmm. That Crafton had a good 10, maybe close to 15-year run. But guess who always been solid? Hip-hop. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I love that, man. I love it.
Man, well, with that being said, would you work with anybody from another, like the West, like down South? I mean, would you work with one of those artists?
Like I said, man, I kind of like, you know, hip hop, boom bap, and it's not too many trap cats like that. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know. I mean, a lot of South cats like that. So I don't know, but I would definitely love to work with more East Coast cats.
I probably would say one that I think would, well, he has done possibly, 2 Chainz or Luda. Luda might be able to hold it down a little bit, I think.
Yeah. Luda spitter, man. Luda spitter. I like Luda. You're right. Luda spitter. I mean, it's a few cats that I wouldn't mind, you know, rocking with if you want to look at it on that level. Yeah, Luda definitely a spitter. I like it.
Yeah, man. I want to play a song, man. I want to get these people involved or in. I don't know what's the correct say. I want to freedom some heat. So no matter where you from, and right now I'm in the Midwest, so we kind of in the middle of everything. So we never really had a side. We were kind of always in the middle. I guess you would possibly say our vibe was always Kanye.
Yeah.
The Kanye vibe was, because he was probably, or Bone Thugs. Bone Thugs, really Bone Thugs. That was our era. But no matter where you from, if you from the West or you from the East Coast, y'all gonna love this album. Y'all gonna love this album, man. I mean, what in particular, what happened exactly that made you decide to do this? I mean, what was it that said, yo, I'm gonna do something, you know, is that vibe?
About it is, man, you know, the era I grew up in, I'm known as a G-Funk artist. And I didn't want that with this album, you know what I'm saying? I love G-Funk, shout out to my G-Funk artists and my G-Funk lovers. But like I said, I wanted to create something timeless, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can listen to this album and you can get that nostalgia feeling, like, I remember that. But it still got its newer elements, you know what I'm saying? Like, G-Funk hasn't really progressed that way where, you know, there's no real such thing as new G-Funk, you know what I'm saying? Mm. I wanted to make sure that I stay current, but give you that feeling. It wasn't no other way to do it than create, instead of West Coast Boom Bap, I mean, instead of Boom Bap, we call it Boom Slap. West Coast Boom Slap.
I like that. All right, let's play Different. That's the single, correct?
That's the first single off the album, yes, sir.
Okay. All right, y'all, let's go. Let's play Different on Spitfire Say the Matches. Yeah.
You think about great people, you think about people that they write stories about, and these great warriors of the past, these great people. What makes those people different? Why are those people special? Those people are known for one reason. It's because they are fucking original. Original.
You're now tuned into the best of the best, Mr. West. Special requests, a rapper not like the rest. To be specific, my mission and definition is instant that when I touch the mic, that
one of these motherfuckers different.
The views are in, you're tuned in. Tell a friend that in the end, the same old shit won't win, cause none.
Motherfuckers different.
If I said it, Mr. Reddit, and the same old shit won't get it. You're from Rage, just a phase, and I'm unapologetic. Flows
different.
Voice
different.
Banging when I slang it, you can hear it from a distance. Beats
different.
Different. No matter how it looks, it's gourmet when we cook it, nigga.
Which of these kids is doing his own thing? Come on, can you tell which one? Can you guess which kid is doing his own thing? Yes, before I'm out on the run. Which of these kids is doing his own thing? Come on, can you tell which one? Can you guess which kid is doing his own thing? Yes, before I'm out on the run.
Yeah, my style. And my flow, when they come, they sound, I still, it took 30 years to understand what we was doing here, but have no fear, just let us steer, my shit is top tier, your shit is basic, so let's face it, shit is garbage, let's replace it with this gutter, grimy basic, rap city, finally made it, I sound like no one, and it's showing, fans is growing, easy going, thanks for glowing, showing such as no one, flows,
different.
Voice,
different.
Begging when I hang it, you can hear it from a distance, and beats,
different.
Different. Knowing what it took, you baking soda when I cook it, nigga.
Which of these kids is doing his own thing? Come on, can you tell which one? Can you guess which kid is doing his own thing? Guess before I'm out on the run. Which of these kids is doing his own thing? Come on, can you tell which one? Can you guess which kid is doing his own thing? Guess before I'm out on the run.
Anyone can be good. But if you want to be great, if you want to be special, if you want to try to get to that next level, it's going to take that much more effort.
Now let's go.
I'm waiting for the rest of the song. Like, yeah, I was waiting for the song to keep going, bro. You cut me up a little bit.
Hey man, I'd have heard that. I'd have heard that before too. Good looking, bro.
Right when I was just about to kick it on. Oh. Scratched. You did the scratching and cutting on that one too?
Yeah, that's me. That's me on the table.
Okay.
Yeah.
How long you been doing that part, the DJing thing?
Oh man, said probably just as long as I've been producing, man. Probably like a good maybe 30, a little bit over 30 years now.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, well, you already I'm not really big on the turntable part anymore. I still can, but how do you feel about the technology with the controllers as opposed to turntables and stuff? Is it, do you have a problem with it, or you think it's, do you say like some older cats say, well, you ain't really DJing because you ain't using turntables?
Turntables. You know, it's nothing like turntables, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's just nothing like those platters, man. The weight of the turntables and the weight of the vinyl and how, you know. So I'm always gonna love that. But you know, man, I kind of get the technology. I've always been into technology like that. You know, I started off right when technology was going. You feel me? Like, mm-hmm. Right. Okay, let's figure it out. I think I got my pads first. And even my mind, I think so unorthodox, man, that when they gave me those pads on my turntables, they just reminded me of NPC pads. So instead of trying to DJ with them, I was trying to make beats with them.
Mm.
Yeah.
Oh, right. I was a little slow. I was the CD cat for the longest, bro. I didn't want to give up my CDJ joints. I didn't want to get them things up for the longest. Cause I was like, because vinyl started to become very difficult to find. You know what I mean? Well, on where we are, I'm sure you guys always had y'all's record stores and y'all could get vinyl. You probably still to this day can get vinyl like it's nothing. But we in the Midwest, it's kind of like hard to find. And then when you do, they want so much for it. It's like, you're killing me, right? You know, $100 for LL Cool J album, bro. Almost.
Real talk, man. Technology, man, burning MP3s and hopping on those CDJs doing what you do. I mean, that's what I'm saying. It was a give and take. You know what I'm saying? Like, I understood. And then I actually saw some cats really trying to learn how to scratch on the CDJs, and some pulled it off. I said, okay, that's dope.
Mm-hmm. So how did you get into actually doing your own production? Did you learn from watching other cats or just...
Yep. Watching Dre, watching Jinx, watching Pooh, DJ Pooh, watching all those cats, man. Yeah, I, like I said, I'm a hip hop head, man. So anything that had to do with hip hop, any of the elements, I, only thing I can't do is graffiti, bro. But everything else, the DJing, the producing, the rapping, the popping, I just wanted to learn it. I just wanted to soak it up like a sponge.
You got any, you got any records for the ladies, man? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like a relationship, slow jam. You know, like a L record back in the day. Did you do anything like that?
I got some songs talking about the ladies and not even in a bad way. Like Latasha. You know, we got a song called A Real One. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I got a couple, you know what I'm saying, dealing with females. But as far as what, just dedicated to the ladies where... You know, I try to get my sexy on. Nah, I ain't.
Hey, yeah, that might be one of your future singles, though. You know what I mean?
Come on.
Yeah. Hey, you come out in the tux, in the tux and some chucks, bro. What's up, man?
I'll leave that to the Drakes, man. Let them do what they.
You ain't gonna be singing or nothing like that.
I can't do none of that, man. I'm from South Central, but you know, I've been living in Compton for about the past 20 years.
Really?
So I just got that in me, man. Where yeah, that's not too cool coming from a cat like me.
I don't blame you, bro. Glasses Malone, bro. That was another cat you work with, man. He's West Coast. Yeah, man. He just recently had a record out with, who was it, man? I'm trying to think. It was somebody.
Young Giants, LA Giants.
Was that who it was? I thought it was somebody from the East, bro. Oh. Was it? I think he had a record with Buff. Not Buff, but Kuwaski. Am I being correct? If I'm correct, I think he had a record with.
No, you're talking about Cocaine. That was Cocaine.
I thought it was Cocaine that had a record. You ever work with Cocaine, bro?
Yeah, I worked with Cocaine a few times with Sugar Free.
Okay. Yeah,
I used a record for Sugar Free called High Heels. And him and Cocaine is on it.
Yeah, John, man. Glasses Malone is nasty. He nice with it. All these cats. Yeah.
Malone is hard, man. G Malone, you know, them is all my little homies, man. All them New West cats. You know, he part of that New West movement. So him, Problem. Kendrick, K Dot, Kendrick, Dim Joints, you know, cats that's doing their thing right now. All them was New West cats.
Okay, New West. Okay, the New West.
Yeah,
Were you always able to work with them? Or y'all always been cool to work with each other? It's never been no. I don't want to work with a young cat, or I don't want to work with an older cat. It's just always just, why, you know, was there ever an issue there?
Opposite, like, you know, they embraced me. You know what I'm saying? Because I was, you know, their whole problem with the older, you know, with my peers was they felt like they wasn't getting a chance. You know what I'm saying? And that's what they really had a problem with. And, you know, I wasn't one of those dudes, you know what I'm saying? Like, they was coming to my studio, they was recording. If they want to sit and talk music, if they want to sit and talk business, you know what I'm saying? I was that dude for them. So they always respected me for that. And I love them dudes for that, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I understood both sides, you feel me? Like, I understood their gripe, but I also told them, knowing how Dre was, knowing how Snoop was, knowing how Q was, you know, that they just wanted to see them dudes take it to a level to where Snoop and them can grab them and say, okay, now y'all ready. And the New West dudes was like, well, you know, why do we have to do all that to show them that we're ready? Because if that's the case, if we get to that point where we're ready, we don't need y'all no more. You know what I'm saying? So I'm good both sides, man. But yeah, it's all love with New West, man. I actually, you know, I went to a couple of their meetings. They had a couple of New West meetings, and, you know, me and Cam went and kind of made sure, you know, their head stayed on and they was focused on what they was trying to do. So yeah, I love them dudes, man.
Wow, you said Cam. What's up with Cam, bro? I heard that David a minute too, bro. That's what's up.
Dude, last time I talked to Cam, man, he was living out of state. He's doing pretty good, man. I think he got a project with Battle Cat. They trying to get that going.
That's what's up. I'm glad to see the West still come, you know, pushing and doing their thing, man.
There's a few of them. JD from the Lynch Mob, you know, he active, man. You know, he been dropping songs, right? The Chill been dropping songs left and right. You know what I'm saying? He done probably dropped about two albums in the course of a year. You know what I'm saying? He produced MC Ren last EP. So, yeah, man, there's a few of us out there still doing it, bro. Like really active with it.
Okay, bring the West back. Bring the West back, man. Bring.
Bro, record together called 30 Years Later. And for the remix, it's I got the Alcoholics. I got the Alcoholics to come together. We knocked out the remix.
Wow, that's
Taz and the crew.
Taz from Ohio. Matter of fact, he's from here. Yeah, he's from here. That's what's up. I got the song. I got it. Let's get into that. Be deep.
Okay, let's do it. Battle Cat.
Yo. All right.
Dazzie Dee,
You can take the G out of the hood, but you can't take the hood out of a G. So we make them see, do the hip, let's dip as we do the west side. Come and take a trip as we flip, gotta keep the doja lit. Snip, let me know, we want your mind to blow. And they never knew about this Bombay one way. Westness, funkness, in the cutlass, and it's me, Dazzie Dee. Let me let you know about a truth from the best. Never been a truth so rich, too much work for this to make it sound so thick. SC, let's we roll, cause they wanna keep it in the closet closed up. Hate getting rolled up, but my knocking out list is like this. True street, no sleeping, still stay knee deep. Make the ghetto red hot when the Glock go pop. It really don't stop, cause cat got the thing to make the hood straight pop. Owning, owning, west side songs, hood songs, songs to keep the hood rats off. And voila, who is the next to go and get my hit to show the west side really right lit? Back to Doja, west side soldier, and they trip on how it stay lit. And they get shook, blowed off the weed soot. And my mad styles just stay off the hook. West side so let's ride to the homie hood. And it's all good when I go get the blue 6-1 switch times 15. Gotta keep it clean as I roll you with motion on these creep me deep. Let's trip. Yes, I got riders that trip. Land of the pop lock, drinking sodas, eating pop rocks. I come with fat songs, rap on, rolling with the hood, finna get my Mac on. Old chose to grow. Now everybody know that I love to hear it by the hundreds. An emphasis on this. I must stop this East Coast, West Coast, wanna be a G. When I get in the incident, I hope it don't trouble you, my man WS. Immediately, I repeatedly, LOC, every day in the SC. Free, yes, it goes deep. And they can't cheat life from the West Side when I bang dip me deep.
That ain't right, some funk man. For you.
Battle Cat, man. Shout out to Battle Cat, man.
Yeah. Salute Battle Cat. Yeah, that was fire.
Hey, Battle Cat's going to from here, like, bro.
That was like maybe 3 years before he even met Snoop. So that sound we cultivated on our own, man. And Snoop and them heard it and was like, man, what's that? We want that. So that's how him and Cat linked up, man.
She hears some Roger Trotman, man. You are so right. This is a boom 2023 timeless. Yes, timeless. We got a lot of cat people coming in. This sounds It does sound like Summertime at the Park. Yeah, back in the day. Oh my God. Yeah, man. The 90s and woo.
Oh, man.
Right.
Dog. You just took me it's back. Crazy. You took a couple people back with that one.
Right. And it's crazy how much that Battle Cap track had like a almost like a DJ Quick feel to it.
Yeah.
Like, just like a little, it had almost like an element. It was almost like he tapped into Quick's bag a little bit and done a couple things. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, that was fire.
Yeah, man. Look, Cat is a real true funkster, man. Cat and Quick. Quick's a funkster too, man. Quick is a little more smooth with his, where Cat is just raw. He got that grind.
Right. That's probably the best way to describe it, for real. That right there was on point. That pretty much sums it up, the difference between the two.
Appreciate it, man. Yeah, and my boys, both of them.
Low 100, I see. Shout out everybody checking in, man. Let's play this joint, man. This is going to be one of y'all's new favorites, man. You did it some justice, bro, for sure.
I appreciate you, homie.
Latasha.
Let's get into it.
I'm going to ask you who Latasha is after this, because... I don't know. Alright, let's go, y'all.
It's your boy Dazzie Dee from that badass WEST. And what you're about to witness is something that used to be the business. And a rider like me stay relentless. So bust a move as we show and prove. And it goes a little something like this. Hit it. I decided to jump in the pencil, roll up the window, release the endo, let the cool air blow. See how my day go. It's no pretending, I'm winning from the beginning. To spin it just like I meant it, make it split it when I end it. And it's a great day, what can I say? Sunday LA, what we fight and love and live to play another day. On my way to the smoke shop, it's a dope spot. Ready to spin the dot and give it all I got, that's off top. I'll be why not make it hop, I'm so in it to win it. That's when I see the soul sister strutting in the distance. She might need assistance, and that's gonna be my mission. And maybe with persistence, she gonna let me beat up in it. I say hi, she say hi, I'm such a nice guy. It's too hot to walk outside, baby, you need to ride. I gave a grin, she hopped in, let the games begin. She smelled that good, as she should, we riders in the wind. Latasha, 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 Latasha. She said it's been a while, and I like your style. I looked and said, like Chinese, baby, I love your smile. In a review, she said, where to? I said, that's all on you. My day was open, so let's chill. That's what a nigga's hoping. You like what I like. You seem to be my type. Thick as a brick, Anna. Fit to be it, Anna. Let's grab some gas, hit the beat, and grab a bite to eat. What else you wanna do? Again, that's all on you. No shame in my game. I'm not the type of lame. To me, it's just the same old same. If you come, you say you came. She said, we're grown, let's be alone. Yep, I'm with it, baby. We got some things, grab some drink and be secret lovers. Yeah, that's what we are. Trying so hard to hide the way we feel. So baby, take this pill. Latasha, 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 Latasha.
Hold up. You know I gotta do this. Real quick.
Party people in a place to be.
Just a little bit.
The one they call MC Precise, just ice on the mic. The one they call DMX on the beatbox. We open it to pleasure. Wide it up.
Latoya.
Wide it up.
Come on, clap your hands, grind it up. Come on, clap your hands. Keep it out while I tell you like this. A fresh little story, be sure you don't miss. It's a scoop for ya. The truth for ya. I could go on for days about this girl named LaToya. I was walking down the block into my side next homeboy DMX. So what the heck? So I saw this fresh girl that I never saw before, but in my heart should be adored and cared for and never ignored. It's a guaranteed love that's highly secured. Daydreaming hard and really getting in and fantasizing my life for 1 or 2 minutes. Then my man DMX just stopped and said,
yo, stop fronting and use your head.
All right. Hey.
That's it.
Yeah. Hey, now you see what I'm saying. He got that feeling, man. That album, the new album just got that feeling. If you understand what real hip hop is, you gotta understand it, man, and really and appreciate it.
Did you, bro, who was that singing, bro? Was that you?
And yeah, the rest? That's me.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Hey, okay. Hey, you know what's funny about that? You know what's funny about it? I was singing it in the studio. And I felt funny singing. I was like, man, am I actually singing right now? So I said, I'm thinking to myself in real time, like, I gotta hood this shit up, right? So I go, try so hard to hide the way we feel. So baby, take this pill. You know what I'm saying? Like, I had to hood it up.
Right.
Oh. Yo, that's right.
Shut up.
Yo.
Yeah.
Might have to do a
slick rig. I was thinking too. Oh, my bad, D. Go ahead.
I was saying you might have to do a slick rig remake joint. You know what I mean?
Man.
Oh, yeah. Hey, that might, yeah, that's fire.
Yeah. Look, I would love to, man. Like I said, it's open, man. It's open. I'm open to whatever. As long as it's pure and it's the essence, man, I'm with it.
I feel that. Yeah, because I was thinking, like, I was listening to the vocals, like, is that Dazzie? Like, wait a minute, who?
Yeah, man.
I was thinking the same thing. Like, I'm gonna have to ask you about that, but then beat to it.
Yeah,
Kevin Thomas, that was nice. Said that was nice.
So let's get into it. Like, who? So what the inspiration of the passion?
Man, look, I was, you know, scrolling down Compton Avenue, actually driving down Compton Avenue one day and seen this little cutie, and that was her name, and it just, you know, Latasha. You feel me? You know how the hood, dude, man, Latasha.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah. So, sure. I came home and sat and thought about it, just started writing, just playing around.
My boy, so I can rock with that.
Yeah, man, look, it was an honor, man. I had fun working on this album, man. Like, all BS aside, bro, with all the scratches and the cuts and the sampling and the chopping the loops and finding, you know, my style, you know, I interrupt my flow to drop in a sample. So finding sample, get all that, man, I just had a ball with this album, bro.
Yeah, and it sounds like that too, though. It sounds like listen to it. You get a feel of, like, yeah, when they was working on this, like, they was really chilling. They was kicking it. Like, it was the vibe of it is, you know what I'm saying? It's a fire vibe, and it's like, yo, that's something I could pop in and say, like they were talking about earlier. That's that Sunday. Let's cruise. Let's hit the park. Let's go chill. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it still give you that boom back bounce though. So where you in the whip line?
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
It's a lot
it's
of.
It's hard to. It's so hard to get to. You know what I mean? To get that feel, especially as us older heads. You know what I mean? Like a lot of what we were accustomed to, I'll say, from the hip hop game has kind of, I ain't gonna say it's lost, but it's kind of, you know, been pushed kind of on the back burner. So to see it slowly rising back to the top, like, yeah, that's, I'm here for it.
Real talk, man. Real talk, bro. I mean, you know, too, man, rap back then, rap was so new to everybody, right? So there was things that we was willing to do and willing to try, whether it worked or not. We tried.
Back.
That's another issue I kind of got with the younger music right now. It's like everybody sound the same, and that's my biggest issue. It's not your talent is there. I don't have a problem with your talent. I just have not want to experiment, just try to do something different.
Right. It's the product. It's like basically like if we liken it, you know, since we always make the hip hop game synonymous with the street. So it's like in the street, it's like, yo, if I got a product I'm selling, you know what I'm saying? And like for instance, we go to American Gangster when your boy was like, hey, he ran down on Mickey Barnes like, yo, you selling my stuff and you rebranded it. You know what I'm saying? It's the same stuff.
Yeah.
And everybody like it. But you took my name off of it now, so that kind of diminishes the product in a sense. And he's like, yo, if you go do that, stamp my name on it. Make sure everybody knows it's that blue magic, you know what I mean? And same thing with the hip-hop game. It's like everybody's kind of following the trend, but nobody wants to either step off to the side and put their own stamp on it, you know what I'm saying, and declare, like, this is what it is, or ride the wave, and everybody riding the wave right now. And that's, you know what I'm saying? And unfortunately, the hip hop game is taking a little bit of a slight hit because of such, because the foundation of the game is originality and individuality. Like, yo, we can come together and do something, but it's going to be my style and your style. It's going to be our styles combined, and also even maybe a you versus me when we get on the track together, because In the early days, that's what it was. Like, yeah, we're going to do this collab, but I'm trying to outrun you on this track.
Yeah, you feel me?
I'm trying to outshine you all together. Like, just know.
Yeah, real talk.
You know what I mean? And so we don't get that the same. Even when a lot of these young cats, when they do collabs, like you said, the talent is there. And the song may be cool, but it's like it's missing something. It's missing that element of competitiveness. Like, yo, I'm not trying to shit on you per se, but yo, I'm trying to outshine you lyrically.
Yeah,
and we you know what I'm saying? We gonna get on this track and see, like, yo, who come with the more fire? And I feel like we gotta get back to that.
Exactly, man. Hey, healthy competition, man. It was just healthy competition. It was hip hop has started being competitive, right? You know, from the battling.
Right.
So yeah, man. But guess what though? That fuels creativity and originality.
But one of the ones that's killing them for me that I have to play before we let you go is Lynch Mob for Life record, bro.
Yeah.
Crazy, bro.
Okay.
Shout out. Yeah.
I can play it and then we can talk about it later, or you can explain how this came about exactly.
Let me break it down. Let me set up the stage, man. What happened was, Jay, you know, for those who don't know, you know, our brother JD, you know, he did 28 in the pen, man, you know, for the mission. And when he got out,
okay, man, I didn't realize he did that long. I thought it was like 15, maybe close to 20.
Yeah, he did it, man. He did every bit of that 28, brother. And you know, so when he got out, man, it just felt right. You know what I'm saying? Like he worked with a few different cats along the way, but he came home, you know what I'm saying? When he came home, we had to do it because we really sat and we thought about it. Like that conversation we had earlier about how the Lynch Mob was just so many factions, it wasn't like a group. We was like, man, we never really sat down and did a song together, like all of us. Like the only two people missing off this record is Shorty, rest in peace, and Ice Cube. Yeah. Everybody else, the entire Lynch Mob is on this record, man, and it just felt good. I'm proud of it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't know Shorty passed. Like, yeah, rest in peace. I didn't even know. Yeah.
Shorty, man, Shorty passed, I think, like 2 years ago.
Man.
Okay. Yeah. I ain't that far off. I don't feel disrespectful by not knowing, you know what I mean? Like, because I was sitting there like, dang, I ain't know Shorty passed. Like, that's crazy.
Yeah, man. Yeah, rest in peace to Shorty, man. But yeah, so we got together, knocked the record out, man. And we was like, okay, this, you know, it got that sound, man. I went back, you know, y'all being DJs, man, y'all understand what I'm talking about. You know, I went back, I want to grab that LA sound. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, people think the West Coast got that a sound, but we do, but it's factions. You feel me? Like, Long Beach got their sound with Snoop, LA sound with Ice Cube and Dub C, and, you know, we just got our own sound, and I kind of wanted to make sure that was portrayed and portray that, make that happen.
Yeah. All right, let's go.
Let's tap into it.
Life, y'all.
Let's get it.
Million.
The legal definition of lynching is when three or more persons, which constitute a mob, and they do it for the purpose of tradition and or whatever their version of justice is.
Lynch mob, lynch mob, lynch mob, lynch mob.
That's time, man. What's the connect info, the social and everything for everybody who may have tuned in late?
I got my Instagram, which is Dazzie D dot OG. So DazzieDee.OG. And then for my Twitter, I got OG Dazzie D. And then same thing for my TikTok, Dazzie D. And then I got Facebook, which is just search Dazzie D. And I got a couple pages that show up, man. And just get at me. I also got my own website, www.dazzied.com. You can go over there and holler at me, man. Yeah, I got a few ways. Like, I ain't hard to find, man.
All right.